Mr. Ali Sajwani, the Group CIO of Emirates NBD, to join me on stage. Thanks for sharing your experience with us. I would like to ask you a few questions about, first, tell us how you innovate, how you continue to keep up with the demand of the market, the board, the Dubai demand that puts on you.
Hello.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning, everybody. And thank you, Nadal and Avaya, for hosting me here on the stage to talk about our experience. And also thank you for presenting our video. Actually, this video we played end of November during the Innovation Week. We had put our Innovation Day of 2016. And like Nadal said, we've had a great success by inviting many of our internal customers, our external customers, and also our stakeholders, plus our partners who work very closely with us. So, and Nadal, to answer you on the innovation side, and like what Farid said, we are all very proud and very happy to be in a city where the leadership and the rulers of the city, of the country, are actually encouraging everybody to become innovative, encouraging everybody to be pressurized to come with their best and the best of their ideas. So the experience which we have established so far, this year we have actually celebrated our fourth Innovation Day. So we have been doing the Innovation Day for 4 years. Today, to this year was our fourth year. And when we started initially, we started it as a small program inside the bank. And I was actually struggling even to get our business heads to come and attend the event. Now, this year, when we had our event, I had external party emailing me and talking to me saying, can we attend? So we have, alhamdulillah, managed over the 4 years to show a lot of success in our innovation. So how do we do it? So the Innovation Day comes during the Innovation Week, which the country celebrates every year in November. And on that day, we actually summarize the work that we have done for the entire year. So throughout the year, what we do, we start from the inside the organization. We do those code jams, and we encourage our technology people, as well as business product managers, to come and sit together and come up with ideas that they find to be innovative. Some of these ideas have been maybe implemented somewhere else in the world with certain technologies, and other ideas are totally fresh and new. And then in addition to that, also what we do, we establish competitions in the schools and universities. We had a very successful innovation event with GEM School this year, and one of their ideas actually presented also during our Innovation Day. We also do the same with universities, with the American universities of Sharjah, with some of the other universities, higher technologies, colleges. In addition to that, what we did this year, which was different actually, in April, we have done our first hackathon in London, in level 39 in Canary Wharf. We invited more than 200 startup companies across the world, fintech companies, to participate and come and in the competition that we have done. And finally, we've shortlisted 20 of those. We invited them to come in London. We've run 2 days a hackathon, and we've selected three startup companies and awarded them. Now, so for us, this whole exercises and whole activities that we have done, especially this year, which we started 3 years back, are giving us more and more insights of how innovation actually is encouraging and making our internal users, our staff, and our employees very excited and very motivated. So we think sometimes that if we make people work overnight or spend their weekend in the office trying to come up with an idea, some people will think that we're actually pressurizing people. Actually, it's the contrary. They come fully charged and very happy and very excited to present.
Ali, if I go back to what Forbes said on the 7, I pick up one. How you relate and how you deploy that, what the board demand versus what you ask the employee to do? How you do that? How you involve everybody to make sure that everybody's buying into the direction of the board?
So the two sides of it, and again refer to the exciting and very impressive speech of Farid, what he said today. We look at our strategy and where we want to grow and how we want to grow. Take this in front of us and use them as a base for coming up with ideas and innovation. At the same time also, look outside the box and find where can we find ideas that maybe they're not really in the pipeline or in the strategy, but they are going to make us differentiated, and they're really going to make us giving type of innovations that will not only impress our clients, our customers, but also add value to them. We find now today that the banking is not only a place where you keep your money or go there to loan, to ask for loans or keep your deposits, right? Banking becomes part of your lifestyle. The bank today is part of your life. When you go in your daily activities, in your shopping, in your requirements, in your process and transactions that you have to do in the different offices, the bank has to be there with you to assist you and to help you, and not only to look after taking your money and giving you a little bit of interest, or giving you some money and then taking from you a lot of interest.
So we partner with the bank, Avaya partner with the bank in the contact center space to move to the first virtual assistant ever. How is Eva doing?
So Eva, or what we say, what we shortened as Emirates NBD virtual assistant, is an innovative idea which was presented in the 2015 Innovation Day along with yourselves. And we have we're almost about to go live with it. Now for our customers who deal with us and customers who are not dealing with us today, which I will invite them also to come and join our bank. Whenever they call the IVR center, if they have to call it, the virtual assistant will give them very, very specialized and very unique type of experience where they talk to the machine, and the machine understands their voice in a very smart way, and you'll be very impressed with the way that it can recognize different dialects and different accents, if I would say. At the same time, also it uses artificial intelligence to come and prompt you to stuff that you are probably have missed. Like if you've missed your pay your credit card bill, or if you have missed to recharge your salik, or if you have missed to pay certain traffic fines. Maybe some of these ideas are not going to be available today, but they are definitely in our horizon to come in the next phase. It becomes your assistant that will solve your problem, similar to how Siri works on your iPhone, where it can help you to become your assistant. Our virtual assistant in the bank will help you also achieve that, maybe initially through calling the call center, and then later on also through a different type of channels that you have handy with you.
So Ali, what's next?
Excellent. So again, I'm excited to talk about this. Future, Bank of the Future, which you have seen in the video and which Nadal spoke about, was an appreciation from the Dubai Future Foundation, where they have invited us to come and be part of the Museum of the Future. So we play out the role of the Bank of the Future. We were, alhamdulillah, successfully able to launch the Bank of the Future, and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid inaugurated the branch in the beginning of October. I invite all of you, whether they are our customers or your potential customers, to go and visit our branch in Emirates Towers. We have managed there to create a space to present 5 ideas, all in coordination with our partners. These ideas go from the robot, the paper robot, and go all the way to the car, the driverless car that can do your transaction for you, and they are very impressive. Now, our plan is to refresh these ideas at least 2 or 3 times, if you are lucky, in a year. Now, the route to do all of this is what we have in the back. So we've also established Emirates NBD Future Lab. And the idea of this Future Lab is not only a space where our staff come down and start research and development activities. It is a space, a showcase, where we want first our partners, and I'm inviting all partners, no exception. If you have any idea, any creative idea that you feel is going to add value to the banking sector, is going to add value to the city of Dubai, to the country of UAE, we are all invited to come and participate with us. Our doors are open for everybody. Now, this Future Lab also eventually will become a showcase for us to start collaborating with our partners outside the technology. What I mean here is that we have noticed in the past years and during the innovation days, every company or every government department of Dubai, they work on their own. So they bring their ideas and they try to encourage their people to become innovative, and they come up with innovative services, maybe sometimes stand alone, only to their own departments. What I think we should do, and I am again stretching my hand to everybody and our ecosystems partners, let us co-innovate together. Our end user, the resident of Dubai, the citizen of Dubai or the UAE, They want an end-to-end experience. They don't want to go do their visa and then come back. They go do their labor card and come back. They do the Emirates ID and come back. They want a journey that starts from A to Z and expect everybody else to coordinate and collaborate together and give one experience to the visitor of Dubai or to the resident of Dubai. And I would have to say that we've also managed to do the first cross-border transaction remittance through using the blockchain. We have announced our first transaction of money remittance with ICICI Bank in India using the blockchain, and this came straight after the announcement of Sheikh Hamdan bin Mohammed bin Rashid to have all government documents of Dubai on blockchain by the year 2020. I am a very big sponsor of blockchain, and I believe blockchain will transform the world, and we will set standards here in Dubai and will be examples for everybody globe on what we're going to achieve together by working very closely with the Dubai Future Foundation and Dubai Smart Government.
Ali, thank you very much. We as Avaya are proud to be a part of it.
Thank you, thank you.